Trello is a web-based project management tool. It is suitable for many applications and it can be used in a huge number of ways. Before you start using Trello, you need to open an account with the Trello website, which is trello.com. It is a free account. They also have a paid version. But for this course and for normal use, if you are using this for your side hustle or for your single to-do list for a couple of projects, the free account is enough for you. So I have created an account and I just log into my account. So once you have logged in, you will be in your boards area. So the first thing you need to understand is the hierarchy in Trello. So because Trello is a project management tool, and most of the times when you are using Trello, you are basically collaborating with other team members. But it is not essential that you must have a team. You can also use Trello as your own to-do list, as I mentioned earlier. At the top of the hierarchy of Trello, we have teams. So a team can have a group of boards. These are my boards. I have recently added a second member into my team. Otherwise, I was working alone on my boards. And these boards, you can think of these boards in various ways. For example, you can say that each board is your one project. For example, I develop courses. So my this board is a project for me for this particular course. And this board is a project for this Trello training course, which I'm currently working on. And if you have a team, then you can make boards for each department of your team. For example, one board for product development, one board for marketing, one board for quality control. So then your boards will represent the department of your team or department of your organization. So then after team, we have boards and each board has lists. So those lists are basically each stage of the project. For example, in this course development, I have a recording phase, then I have a pre-production phase, then I have a final review phase, and then I have a launch phase. So these are some of the phases in my course development project. And this board is, for example, my own training. I'm currently doing a diploma in training design. So this board represents my own training program, which I am participating in. So in this board, the stages will be different. This is the beauty of Trello. It has a very simple interface, but there are a huge number of ways you can use Trello. And when you will see people using Trello in innovative ways, you will be fascinated with how many options you have. So you can learn the basics of Trello in half an hour. But in order to get full potential of Trello, you may need years of experience. So Trello is a very powerful project management tool. And in today's lesson, we will learn the three basic organizational units of Trello. After teams, we have boards, then lists, and then cards. So this is the organizational hierarchy of Trello. So first I will show you one of my boards and then we will start creating a board from the scratch because I don't want to confuse you. So first I will highlight you one of my boards. So if I click on this board, you will see that this board has these vertical blocks which are lists, first list, second list, and so on. And in each of these lists, we have these cards. So list is a workflow. And what is a workflow? Workflow is a way you do the task. So there could be many possible workflows. For example, your cards could be moving stage by stage from left to right. Your cards could be staying in the same list. And when one task is completed, these card straight away go to the completed list. So these are called workflows. The way you move the card, the way you collaborate, the way you work in a team, the way you manage the project or organize your project. So these are called the workflows. So there are so many ways and so many workflows are available for different type of application. For example, if you are doing a project management, you will move these cards in a specific manner from one stage of the project to the other stage of the project. If you are doing a product development, then the way you move the card will be different. And if you are studying something and you are organizing your studies, or you are organizing a marriage, or you are organizing your family vacations, you move the cards in a totally different way. So this is the beauty of Trello, that you can work on Trello in various ways. And I will be showing you various kinds of boards and all the features in future lectures. But this is just a highlight of how a board look like. And now we will start from scratch. If I click on this home, I will go back to this. And now in order to create a new board, you have to just click on this, create a new board, and then you give it a name. So I just say project one or something, and there are two kinds of boards: private, where only board members can see and edit the board, and public, so anyone on the internet can see the board, but only board members can edit the board. And we will be creating a private board here, so just create board. And there is a background picture here. If you like, you can use it. Some people think that background picture is motivational, looks good, but personally I use only a plain background. So in order to change the background, you click on this change background, and there are some colors available. If you are on a paid plan, then you can also upload your own background colors and images, but I'm on the free plan, so I will use one of these. So let's say this one. So as soon as you create a board, you will be prompted with add a list. And you can add your first list here. So I will say stage one, for example. This is stage one of my project, and I add list, and then I can add another list, stage two, add a list, and then I can say complete it. So this is a completed list. So this is just a simple board. If you don't want any further list, you just click on this. So this is how you add a list into a board, and then each list can have many cards. In order to create a card, just click on add card, and then I would say task one, because essentially it's a task. Add card, task two, and then you can just close this. Similarly, you can add two tasks here, task one, task two, and then just close it. And now we have created a board, three lists and few tasks. And now, for example, when this task is complete, you can just drag and drop it to this completed task, and then you are left with this task. Then you just, if this is complete, you can take that to the completed task. And this is how you complete the task and move it to the completed list. So it's a good practice to name these lists in a more descriptive manner. I'm just naming this stage one, stage two, just to make you understand that these are essentially different stages of your project. For example, these are your ideas, then these are your currently in progress tasks, and these are your completed tasks. So these could be different way to organize your project. So these are three basic organizational units in Trello: boards, lists, and cards. Now, a few things I would like to mention here, because this is just the first lecture, and I don't want to put too much material in this, but few things I would like to add. So let's say I go back to my boards, and I have created this board, but I want to, let's say, delete this board. So in order to delete this board, there are two ways. One is to archive the board, to close the board, and close means that you can reopen the board at any time later on, and all these boards and everything is stored on cloud on Trello website, so you don't have to worry about. If you want to delete, so how to do that? So you just click on the board first, and then on the right hand side there is a menu here, and in this menu you will click on more, and there is a button at the end, close board. If you click on close board, it will prompt you to confirm. You just confirm close, and now your board is closed. If you want, you can reopen it anytime, or if you want to permanently delete the board, you can permanently delete board here. So I would just reopen the board, and now my board is back. So this is the way if you want to delete a board. So now we have created a board, and we have added list and cards to the board. And in the next lecture, we will see some of the details, how to add a detail to a card.